existence like ours must reflect such a divergence of interest within its power base.
Agree, Rogers? Yeah, I think Judith's point of view is very valid, Rick. Provided the movement never forgets that it is the inalienable right of every man
or woman
to rid himself
or herself.
Agreed.
Thank you, brother.
Or sister.
Where was I?
I think you finished.
Oh, right.
Furthermore, it is the birthright of every man
or woman.
Why don't you shut up about women, Stan? You're putting us off.
Women have a perfect right to play a part in our movement, Reg.
Why are you always on about women, Stan?
I want to be one.
What?
I want to be a woman. From now on, I want you all to call me Loretta.
What?
It's my right as a man.
Well, why do you want to be Loretta, Stan?
I want to have babies.
You want to have babies?
It's every man's right to have babies if he wants them.
But you can't have babies.
Don't you oppress me.
I'm not oppressing you, Stan. You haven't got a womb. Where's the fetus going to gestate? You're going to keep it in a box?
Here, I've got an idea. Suppose you agree that he can't actually have babies, not having a womb, which is nobody's fault, not even the Romans, but that he can have the right to have babies.
Good idea, Judith. We shall fight the oppressors for your right to have babies, brother. Sister, sorry. What's the point?
What?
What's the point of fighting for his right to have babies when he can't have babies? It is symbolic of our struggle against oppression.
Symbolic of his struggle against reality.